Hello, student. We hope you all are well, in sound health and good spirit. I welcome you all once again today in this online briefings of our specified courses of personality grooming. I hope that you have already gone through my earlier videos also. At first, let me express all of our best wishes to each of you on behalf of George Telegraph Smart Center, Srirampur, and on all of our personal behalf. Now, students, we have already discussed about the common interview question in my earlier video. There I could able to complete only one question, that is the first question, tell about yourself. I think you have already gone through it and you have grasped it. What is more important? To grasp in it. And perhaps this is the best time where you can get that kind of opportunity, because in classroom it may not be able to rewind it and re-listen it once again. But here you can listen all the questions, all the probable answer again and again as and when you are getting time. Okay, now coming to the subject matter directly. Today we will discuss the concluding portion of the other questions. Now the first question, what I will pick up, the probable question is, what according to you are your strength and your weakness? This is a very tricky question, my dear student. In fact, many of us know our strength very well, but we are not that much of aware about our weakness. No, they are not asking you about your physical strength or physical weakness. Okay, they are asking you about the traits of as a candidate for this job. Now, as far as strength is concerned, well, you can start with this. Well, sir, as far as strength is concerned, I think my major strength is I am a sincere, honest person. I am a quick learner. I'm a good listener, so it's a very good strength, you know. Okay, so you must highlight this. I'm a good listener. I'm flexible, of course, time to time or situation to situation. I'm perfectionist and I am approachable. As people says that I can make friends well, and the people has no problem to communicate with me. So these, I think, is my major strength. And as far as my weakness is concerned, I could find out two major weakness which I am working out also to recover this area. Now the first weakness is, as I told that I am a perfectionist. To get the things in a perfect way as per my choice, I usually spoil much of valuable time. I am looking on that, and I am trying to overcome this shortfall also. In fact, in my college days, I have found that I have finished my project. I could have finished my project much earlier than to give in deadline, but due to my perfectionist nature, I could not finish it in earlier. Of course, I made it within the deadline. Anyway, sir, in this way, I think I am spoiling much of my valuable time, for which I am really concerned, and I am working on that so that both way I can maintain. The first way, I can be I can maintain my perfection, and second way, I can save my time. And the second is, I can communicate well in my mother tongue. But yes, I have certain weakness or certain poor in communication as far as fluency is concerned in English. And this is more important where I am working on that. I have already admitted in a course of spoken English and personality grooming at George Telegraph. And I am undergoing this course. I am trying to learn it very quickly and practice it in the practical field. So I think this these are certain major strength and weakness which I could identify, sir. Okay, that will be one of the best answer for you that I think your interviewer will like to get this kind of reply from a candidate. But one thing you must, you should not utter it like a parrot. You should utter it with confidence, with your body language, with your posture, with your gesture. These things should come out from you so that interviewer also get convinced that candidates are not telling something which he has been learned to tell. No, you are telling it from your level of confidence. Okay, that kind of body language, that kind of gesture, that kind of posture, you must exhibit in front of your interview. Okay, I think it is clear now. You can add some of the strength or weakness, but for heaven's sake, don't add some of the personal traits of your, like, I am very loose in temper and I am very emotional. Yes, you are, every human having, but that is not the area which you want to identify in front of your interviewer, because the interviewer will not take it in a right way and they will create a bad impression about you. Okay, that the person cannot present himself. So be careful on that particular way. Your personal trait is your own asset or liability, that is different. But you should not highlight it in case when you are appearing for interview. And the second thing, whenever the camera focuses on you for your photograph, you usually gives a pose. Okay, your friends are asking, chalo ek photograph lele, then you are posing. The same way you will have to pose in an interview also. It may not be very real as far as your appearance is concerned, your character is concerned, your trait is concerned, but on that particular point, on that particular 10 minutes, you will have to use it in a beautiful manner. Okay, so that you can be selected. So I'm coming to the next question. Okay, this is a very vital question. We have quite a lot of candidates for the job. So why should you appoint you? Now, again, the level of confidence will be checked. Okay, of course, there are so many candidates are waiting outside, as you have seen also. But the vacancy is not as many as the candidates are present here. So what you will have to show? You will have to show with your confidence level. Okay, now you see, you just say, whatever job you have applied for, you just say that, sir, this is one of my dream job right from my childhood. I have prepared myself to take up this profession when I'll complete my study. So as I am here to get my dream job, I think that I have already acquired the required qualities and the talents and the skill for this particular job. So I can be considered as one of the best candidates. That is the only answer by which you can impress your interviewer and you can support your candidature. Okay, so be careful to show your confidence. That should not be overconfident. At the same time, it should not be your underconfidence. Okay, you should be very careful while you are presenting this sentence that I have chosen this job as a dream job from my childhood. So I have prepared myself to take up this job while I will complete my study, and today I am here to utilize this opportunity. So I think I am the best candidate, and as I have all the skills and talents and willpower to achieve the success in this profession, in whatever profession you are going there. Okay, if you are going for a clerical interview in bank, if you are going for any frontline executive interview in any telecom company, or you are going for the profession of teacher, I mean faculty position, whatever it is, in wherever you are, Okay? You will have to pose like this that you are confident and it's your dream job right from your childhood. So you have prepared yourself to take up this job in a serious mode and you are very confident that you will achieve success if you have been selected or if you have been given the opportunity to get this job. I think I am clear to you. Okay? If you cannot if you cannot follow this, please listen it once again. Okay? Listen it again and again so that you can follow it. Okay? You can grasp it. Now the next question I am coming. Which is more important to you, status or salary? Okay? Here also you will have to make a pause. Of course, the money is more important to everybody. I also want to get more money in my life. Everybody. Okay? And but the way you will present it in a different manner. When the question will be put, you will say with humbleness, sir, well, salary is very important. But it is more important to me is my status. My status means I am enhancing my knowledge, my skill, and I am enhancing my position in my profession. And that is more important, to get the social prestige, to get the family prestige, to get the prestige among colleagues. This is more important. And of course, when my status will be enhanced, automatically my earnings will also will take care and it will also get enhanced. So I am more favor in I am more in favor of status compared to salary. When my status will be higher, automatically my remuneration, my earnings will be higher. So to me, the first choice is my status. Okay? Though you will first highlight that yes, sir, salary is important because I am here to get my remuneration, as I am here with an expectation that you will hire me and you will give me the salary in every month. Okay? But at the same time, you put first the status. Why it is? Because when the employer seeks the candidates, they usually wants to find out that who are the candidates on which the organization has certain future. That means you can be a future leader. You can be a future holder of the organization. You can be an asset for the organization. If you are very casual as far as your status is concerned, as far as your position is concerned, as far as your portfolio is concerned, as far as your responsibility is concerned, then and you are only money hunker, then you are not the right kind of candidate whom they are seeking for. They usually seek this kind of candidate who are very eager to enhance their knowledge, enhance their skill, enhance their position within a very short time in the organization. In that way, organization will also grow. The more you will grow, the organization will also grow. And that is the main point where you will have to highlight that I want to grow with the organization very fast. And for that reason, I want to enhance my position, enhance my responsibility, and enhance my skill, enhance my knowledge, and I want to contribute more to the organization. The way you, when you will be ready to give more contribution to the organization will enhance your position, enhance your responsibility, and automatically your status will be higher. And when your status will be higher, automatically you will find that your earnings getting more. And that is the main motto. Okay? And for that reason, you will get much of prestige in the society, in your family, to your children, to the colleagues. Everybody will start looking you in a better way, in a different way, that you are one of the successful person. And the company also will be benefited from your greater contribution. So you should always focus on your status and not you know your salary. That you have never seen that a general manager is getting the salary of any full class staff or sub staff. Okay? So whenever your status will be higher, automatically your remuneration will go up. Automatically your earnings will go up. Automatically your position will go up. So you should put status at the first. Okay? But you should appreciate at the same time the salary part also. Fine? I think it is clear now. If you have any doubt or any lack of clarity on that particular matter, and if you find out certain question which is coming out of your way, if we get an opportunity to interact with you on online, I will definitely create such kind of situation. If does not happen, then we will take up this, you please note it down, we will take up this matter as and when we will get the next opportunity to meet with each of you in our classes. Okay, now the next is, which how long do you think you'd stay with us if you are appointed? I said you already that this question specifically being put to the girls, because they thinks, the employer thinks that the girls are easy tend to get married, and when they will be married, when they would be married, they will definitely leave the job and they will be busy with their family affairs. Okay? So again, you should have to give their confidence that it is not going to happen. Okay? Now, if this question is asked directly to you, that how long do you think you would stay with us if you are appointed the, for the girl student, you should tell in this way, sir, as I told you already that it's a dream job for me and I kept it as my dream job right from my childhood, and I have prepared myself to take this profession and get the success in this profession, and it is not come immediately, it is coming from my childhood days. So I will never allow to happen anything's come in between my service, my profession, my choice, and my personal matters. So that you will have to say with confidence, so that they can get confidence out of your conviction that, well, this girl is very serious as far as this profession is concerned. Otherwise, most of the time they will start thinking that why I should waste my time, why I should waste my money, why I should give her the training after taking all these things, after 2 years, 3 years or 4 years, she will get married and she will leave the job. And again, we will have to look after another girl. So it is better not to take. Okay? So you should have to clear this. You should have to clear this idea from their mind that you are not such kind of girl. You are very serious as far as your profession is concerned. So, and for the boys, if the boys has been asked, the question will be same way, because they are thinking about the about your leaving the job. Okay. In fact, many of the organization have seen that some of the boys, they are very fond of job hopping. Okay. So job hopping is now a real concern to the good organization, because some of the good organization, they usually arrange for a good training for their people. Now, after getting the training, after giving some service for 6 months, 1 year, then they leave the job. They go for the better. And whenever they have been asked why you are leaving the job, they will say that it's a better job. What is better? About 500 rupees, about 1000 rupees, about 2000, 3000 rupees increasing, and they are leaving the job. So now the companies are also becoming very, very careful about selecting the candidate. Okay? It has been seen, And in the industry also, some of the vulnerable industry, like those who are mass recruiters, like telecom industries, like IT industries, like banking industries, they are now started thinking in a different way. They are now taking the bond from the candidates. In fact, in IT industry, it is very common that you will have to sign a bond that you cannot leave the job within specified time, like 1 year or 2 years. If you, by chance, if you want to leave this job, you will have to pay a compensation to the organization. And this is a hefty sum. So they are making it to retain the talents, to retain the people, because they don't want to go continuously recruiting the people. Recruiting the people, train the people, giving the job, then after 6 months, again, they'll have to go to the square back. That they exactly don't want. They want to avoid it. So what they are doing now? They are making this bonding system, which was not earlier. Okay? Now they are doing that because the attrition rate is very high. Now the IT attrition rate is around 30 to 32%. That means if 100%, 100 people are getting selected and they are entering in the job, after 6 months or 1 year, 30 people are going away. Now, it's a loss to the organization. Again, a company has to increase their workforce. Again, they have to train to them. And that's a tedious process. So they also put this question to the boys. They want to see that how much confident they are. Okay? See, of course, if you get a good job, should you not leave this job? Of course, you will leave this job, but in the interview session, you should answer it with little tricks. I said that when you will be under focus, I mean, in front of camera, you will have to give a good pose. And when you are appearing for an interview, the same thing happens. You will have to impress your interviewer so that your interviewer creates certain good idea about you before considering your candidature and before selecting you. Okay? Now, how you will present it? With your confidence, with your body language, with your posture, you will show your confidence like this, that, sir, as I have told you that it's a dream job for me, I have prepared myself to suit for this profession only. And I want to achieve success in this field only. So there is no question of leaving the job. Okay? I want to get much more skilled and I want to grow with the growth of this organization. This organization is one of the best organizations. If it is best multinational, then you can jolly well say this. If it is a startup organization, like this company is not known to everybody, this company is not very famous so far, you can say, you can put in a different way that, sir, I have never thought of to go to knock to the multinational companies. I want to start my career with a startup organization, which is little known because that is the right place where I can bloom, where I can get a lot of opportunities to innovate, to explore, and to learn many new things, which will definitely enhance the level of my knowledge, the level of my skill, and it will definitely encourage me to go ahead in the profession with my growth, of course, with the organizational growth too. Now, this way you will have to play with this question. And if it is multinational, you say, sir, this organization is one of the best in industry. This is a multinational organization. Multinational means they have their business activities in the other countries too. If it is a national, good national company, then you can highlight that, sir, this is a very good organization. Pan India, their activities are available. Okay? So if I get an opportunity to serve this organization, I will definitely utilize my best of time here and I will see that I am learning many things from here which by which I can enhance my knowledge, my skill, my position, my portfolio, and my status also. Okay? So in this way, you will have to gain the level of the confidence of your interviewer. Now, your interviewer will definitely try to assess you by the way you are answering them. If you try to be over smart, you will be caught. Better to be on your smart level and say all these things with your confidence. The only thing, gentlemen, I can tell you, the only thing usually being judged in an interview, the level of your confidence. See, when you are in an interview session, suppose it's for graduate, suppose it is for undergraduate, you cannot segregate the other candidates also. They are also having the same cheat of mark sheet. Okay? They have also passed the they have also completed their study, they have also passed that examination which you passed. Okay, so how they will segregate it? They will segregate it with your communication ability, with your level of confidence. With the level of your confidence, if you can answer all the questions of these five common questions which has been put to the freshers, I can challenge that you will emerge with the victory. Okay? I just want to tell one thing, my dear student. Don't take any interview casually. Whenever you will get any interview, be serious. Take time. Okay? Take your homework. This homework is very much required. They want to know from you that what do you know about our company. Now, whatever company, from whatever company you are getting the interview, you please try to get certain information about the company. Where from you will get it? Now, the availability is within your hand. The Google is available. Okay? Ocean of information. You type the website of that particular company. You can get certain information. You need not to go through all the information, but certain features of this information, of this company's information, you must grasp. You must memorize. What you memorize? What is the activities of the company? Where they do these activities? Okay? And what is the future planning of this organization? And how, as a candidate, if you have been selected, you can contribute in their future planning. That if you can do, I can foresee it that you will be a selected candidate. Now, if it is not that much of a famous company, try to get certain information from the market, try to get certain information from the people who are working there, okay? And a few information. The interviewer will be happy to know from you that before attending an interview session, you made a homework where you have identified where the area of the company's activities and the future planning of the company and related to features of the company. They actually want to see that this candidate will be much more serious as far as our company is serious, because they are appearing in an interview in front of us to get the job in this company. Okay? So I think I have touched all the 5 points. It is better in that position or in that situation. I conclude here with these 5 questions of our interview session. In the next session, I will take up certain other activities with through our video. And it's a beautiful system, this online system. I must thankful to our organizer, our institution, that they have given us this opportunity to come to present ourselves in front of you so that you can get certain benefit out of it while you are in the home as a confined person. We are also confined person. We can also make use of this, and in this way we can keep a touch with our student. With this, I am concluding today's deliberation. These all 5 questions I have attended. Please go through, please listen it again and again. If you have any lack of clarity, if you need any better clarification, if you have any doubt, note it. Whenever we will get the opportunity, I will definitely try to clear this doubt for each of you. Okay? With this, once again, I am thanking you for staying with me, for listening me, and I am again wishing you stay safe, stay at your home, take care of the elders, and make use best of your time to learn new things. Okay, this is also a new things, this online learning, Gapseed, other home-oriented task which you think is new, make use of your time, get it, learn it. Thank you. Wish you all good days. Once again, I am your English teacher. Goodbye for today. Thank you.